हाय, आई एम एजा शेख फ्रॉम के केवा आर्ट्स कॉमर्स साइंस कंप्यूटर साइंस कॉलेज काका साहेब नगर। लेट अस सी दी एस वाई बी एस सी कंप्यूटर साइंस इलेक्ट्रॉनिक्स पेपर सेकंड डिजिटल कम्युनिकेशन एंड नेटवर्किंग विद द हेल्प ऑफ रेफरेंस बुक कम्युनिकेशन सिस्टम बाय द ए बी कार्सल, पी बी क्रीली एंड जे सी डूडलल्स। Now, the wireless communication system use electromagnetic spectrum. Electromagnetic spectrum consists different frequency ranges, which are from DC to ultra high frequency ranges. These different electromagnetic spectrums are used in a different applications. For example, we see that for a power supply or telephone communication, we use a low frequency band. For twisted pair communication, we use a very high frequency bands. For coaxial cable communication, we use ultra high frequency bands. For amplitude modulation, we use medium frequency and high frequency bands. For frequency modulation or FM radio communication and TV communication, we use very high frequency or ultra high frequency bands. For terrestrial or satellite communication, we use super high frequency, ultra high frequency bands. Then infrared, visible lights and optical fiber cables. Now, what is modulation and demodulation? Modulation is the process in which any one parameter of a information signal is changed in accordance with the amplitude or the magnitude of information signal. The modulation is the process in which the baseband signal or the information signal is superimposed on high frequency carrier signal. We can see that the block diagram of modulation or modulated system, in which it consists the baseband signal and high frequency RF oscillator. The baseband signal is modulated with the help of modulator, which create a modulated signal and transmit it through transmission medium. It may be wired or wireless. If the signal is transmitted through wireless communication, then it must consist antenna. In the modulation process, any one parameter of the carrier signal, that is amplitude or frequency or phase, varies in accordance with the magnitude of modulating signal. This modulated signal is then transmitted by the transmission or transmitter. Similarly, in contrast with the modulation, demodulation exactly opposite process of modulation. In demodulation, the original information signal recover or extracted from the modulated signal. That is, the modulation is the process, opposite process of modulation. There is the varying amplitude, the frequency or the phase of carrier signal is extracted to the construct the original massive signal. So it consists RF amplifier, local oscillator, demodulator and then baseband amplifier. What is the need of modulation? First, we can see that the reduction of height of antenna. The height of antenna is reciprocal of its wavelength. If wavelength increases, height of antenna decreases. That is, if the frequency increases, height of antenna decreases. Hence, if we modulate a low frequency signal with a high frequency modulating signal, then the height of antenna automatically decreases. Then increase the range of communication. By modulation, we can increase the range of communication. We can multiplex the large number of information signal through single transmission medium. Then improve the quality of reception and to overcome the problem of hardware. So these are the needs of modulations. Then types of modulation. Basically there are three types of modulations: analog modulation, digital modulation, pulse modulation. In analog modulation, there are amplitude modulation, angle modulation, which consists of frequency modulation, phase modulation. In pulse modulation, it divides into analog pulse and digital pulse. Analog pulse is further divided into pulse amplitude, pulse width, and pulse position modulation, where digital pulse modulation divided into pulse code modulation, delta modulation, and adaptive delta modulation. While the digital modulation is again further divided into three parts: amplitude shift keying, frequency shift keying, and phase shift keying. Then the combination of amplitude phase shift keying and phase shift keying is the QAM, quadrature amplitude modulation. Then analog modulation technique. In analog modulation technique, the carrier signal and information signal both are in analog form. That is, the any one parameter means it may be amplitude or frequency or phase of carrier signal changes in accordance with the magnitude of information signal. So there are three types of analog modulations: amplitude modulation, frequency modulation, phase modulation. We can see the modulated signals: amplitude modulated signal, frequency modulated signal, and phase modulated signal. So these are the diagrams related to the amplitude modulation and their mathematical expressions and electromagnetic output spectrum of amplitude modulation. The bandwidth is nothing but the difference between the upper sideband and lower sideband. So the amplitude of the bandwidth of the amplitude modulated signal is 2 fm, where fm is the frequency of modulating signal or information signal. If you consider the block diagram of the amplitude modulated signal or amplitude modulated system, it consists of amplifier. It consists audio amplifier, amplitude modulator with radio frequency oscillator, then RF power amplifier and antenna. Then at the reception, for demodulation, it consists amplifier, IF stage, detectors, and amplification. The digital modulation techniques get divided into mainly two parts: constant envelope and non-constant envelope modulation techniques. The constant envelope modulation techniques consist FSK, PSK, that is frequency shift keying and phase shift keying, while the non-constant envelope consists ASK and Mary QAM, that is amplitude shift keying and quadrature amplitude modulation technique. The digital modulation techniques, in which ASK means amplitude shift keying. In digital modulation technique, the information signal is in a digital form while the carrier signal is in analog form. So according to the logic level of digital information signal, the amplitude or phase or frequency of analog information carrier signal changes. Here we can see that the pulse modulation technique, in which analog pulse modulation, digital pulse modulation.